You're watching Tag TV.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Emma, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of our country's diversity. In India, every region has its own style and pattern of art, popularly known as folk art, which is very ethnic and simple, yet colorful and vibrant enough to speak volumes about country's rich heritage. Though with modernization, some of these folk art forms are dying a slow death, but still there are many who have kept their charm alive. One among them is a traditional form of theatre in Manipur, which for last many years is playing a great role in connecting the younger generation to its traditional roots of art and culture.
Dressed up in traditional tribal costumes, several folk artists in the eastern state of Manipur presented the brilliant performances at the 17th Shumang Lila Festival held in the capital, Imphal. Shumang means open courtyard and Lila means play, and thus, as its meaning suggests, it is performed in an open courtyard surrounded by spectators on all the four sides. This year, around 18 female and 12 male Shumang Lila groups participated in the festival. While the play title Kaibulam Jao Ki Tamnalai was showcased by Moshangai Women Shumang Lila Kangloop, the second play, Laman, was presented by Kangjabi Mitai Chanu Artist Kam Drum Association, among others. Organized annually by the Manipur State Shumang Lila Council, the festival attempts to familiarize the younger generation with the traditions, history and art form of the region and its tribes.
Angangsing light lai shoot tamu angangsing hai tare ko graduation tau dana art ki maram da any graduation mat lai ro kambu na lila simi yeng matam da moida koi research sama tau bolu hukum jan adu dana sumang la da babu oi ba lakar ba kambu kumsi babu oi dana lakar ba kambu eh si de akoi si yau bu yam jan ni nai dana sum song chelak pa di sum song chelak pa di mamai da di o o masigi sana pham lai re kalsa university ka su lak pa ni na ko aduna soi dana maki Sanabam Lerani, Kanabam Lerani, Havisimuna, Kangbugalina, Hojikse, Tongan Tonganba, Kanabaka, Sakot Pakayazi, Hinkale, Hajitamjani.
Performed at every nook and corner of the state, particularly the valley area, there are a number of great Shumang Lila plays in the history like Imphal Babu, Daku Jagat Singh, Abir Khan, Hamlet, and many more. These plays are so popular that even a commoner in the state can easily recite 2-3 lines from them. Traditionally, all roles were performed by male actors in Shumang Lila, some dressed as beautiful ladies. However, with time, women have also started to participate in the plays. Amid COVID-19, the artists who were at home for a long time were happy to finally showcase the performance on stage. Today, Shumang Lila has crossed the boundaries of linguistic and cultural barriers and has gained exposure among other societies as well. Though this traditional form of theatre changes its looks according to time and situation, however, it has maintained its gravity without any change for a long time.
Opening talk. India is famous around the world for being home to a number of different castes, religions and ethnic groups. Example of peaceful coexistence between these communities can be seen in every nook and corner of the country. A similar example was recently seen on the occasion of Mahashivratri in Varanasi city of Uttar Pradesh, where Muslims showered petals on Shiv devotees.
Devotees in Varanasi's famous Vishwanath temple stood in long queues on the auspicious occasion of Mahashivratri as they waited eagerly for their turn to perform the holy rituals on Shivaling, an abstract representation of Hindu deity Lord Shiva. As Hindu devotees stood in queues, people of Muslim community were seen showering petals on them to give out the message of brotherhood in line with the Ganga Jamuni Tehzeeb. This culture refers to the fusion of Hindu-Muslim cultures found in northern states like Uttar Pradesh, especially the region that falls between the banks of Ganges and Yamuna rivers.
यहाँ पर गंगा जमुनी तहजीब है, यहाँ बगल में गंगा जी हैं, यहाँ का पानी से मुसलमान वजू करता है, हिंदू स्नान करता है, और बाबा भोलेनाथ की नगरी है, यहाँ पर कुछ नहीं है, यहाँ पर सिर्फ भाईचारा है, हम ईद भी मनाते हैं, होली भी मनाते हैं, शिवरात्रि भी मनाती हैं, जब कांवड़ आते हैं, तो यहाँ पर हम उन पर पैर भी धुलवाते हैं, तो यहाँ बड़ा मिलजुल कर रहा जाता है।
This was not for the first time that such a wonderful gesture was shown by the people of a particular community in Varanasi. Locals say that be it the festivals of Hindus or Muslims, we celebrate each and every festival together, and the same was witnessed during Mahashivratri.
सब लोग मिलजुल के रहते हैं हमारे यहाँ ईद पर मेरी फ्रेंड्स लोग आती है मेरे घर पे सेवैयाँ खाने के लिए उनको बहुत पसंद है और होली पर हम जाते हैं उनके यहाँ दही बड़ा खाने के लिए हमको बहुत पसंद है तो हम लोग सब लोग मिलजुल कर एक दूसरे के साथ होली हुआ या दीपावली हुआ या ईद हुआ हम सब मिल करके सेलिब्रेट करते हैं और काफ़ी खुशी के साथ सेलिब्रेट करते हैं और हम लोग को लगता नहीं है कि कौन किस मज़हब का है हम लोग ये सब समझ ही नहीं पाते हम सब यही जानते हैं कि सारे त्यौहार हमारे अपने हैं
Celebrated with great fervor and zeal across the country, Mahashivratri is considered most auspicious for spiritual growth. Literally translating to the great night of Shiva, the occasion is believed to celebrate the marriage of Shiva, the lord of destruction, and Parvati, goddess of fertility, love, and beauty.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A 32-year-old woman in India's southern Tamil Nadu state created a world record by becoming the youngest woman to rappel blindfolded from a 155-feet rock hill in a bid to inspire women around the world. N. Muthamil Selvi rappelled blindfolded from a rocky hill at the state's Malaipattu mountain, 40 kilometers from capital city of Chennai in 58 seconds and entered the UNESCO Book of World Records.
I'm happy for this world record. Let women shine in the world. Let all men support all women.
Today, women around the world are breaking gender stereotypes and doing wonders in various fields, and Selvi is one among them. Impressed by Indian art and culture, Ileana Sitaristi came to Odisha in the year 1979. Conferred with Padma Shri Award in 2006, Sitaristi decided to make Odisha her home and has been imparting the knowledge of Odissi dance forms since 1995. Apart from being the first classical dancer of the foreign origin to be conferred with the honor, Sitaristi has also won the 43rd National Film Awards for Best Choreography in 1995.
I was not expecting it. I really didn't do anything for it, so it was the most surprise news which I got on 26 January of 2006. And I'm very happy that my father was still conscious and alive. Unfortunately, he died after 20 days of that, but when I came to know, I could call him back and I could give the news to him. So that was, and of course then when the award was given on a few months after, that was a great experience.
She has been imparting training in Odissi and Chau to students in Bhubaneswar in her institute Art Vision. Italian by birth, Sitaresti holds her doctorate in philosophy with a thesis on psychoanalysis and Eastern mythology. Her mentor in Odissi dance style is the renowned guru Padma Vibhushan Kelu Charan Mohapatra. An elderly couple in India's northern Aligarh city is making a gigantic lock weighing over 300 kilograms to promote the trade and their work. Locksmith Satya Prakash Sharma, whose family has been in this trade for over 100 years, is making the fully functional lock and a key along with his wife Rukmani Sharma.
एक ताला ये बनाया है जिससे अलीगढ़ की पहचान करने के वास्ते हमने ये ताला बनाया है. इसकी चौड़ाई है 2 फुट 9.5 इंची और लंबाई है इसकी 6 फुट 2 इंची और इसमें सभी फंक्शन जैसे चाबी लगाना खोलना ये सभी फंक्शन है इसमें केवल दिखावटी नहीं है.
The lock which is still in the making has been made using around 60 kilograms of brass and the rest of it is iron. Aligarh City is amongst the largest manufacturers and suppliers of locks in the country.
Sufism has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. This can be well witnessed during the Urs of Sufi saints when people cutting across religious lines gather under one roof. So giving a glimpse of this unique devotional culture, today we take you to the Urs commemoration of Jan Mohammad Sahib that was recently commemorated in Rajouri.
The shrine of Sufi saint Jan Mohammad Sahib, located in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri town, is an abode of peace and tranquility. Every year, thousands of people, irrespective of their caste and community, throng the shrine to commemorate the death anniversary or Urs of the Sufi saint, who throughout his life spread the message of oneness and brotherhood.
यहाँ से ये अल्लाह वालों के दरगाहों से जो है पूरी दुनिया के अंदर ये एक अमन और शांति का पैगाम है कि यहाँ देख लो कोई मजहब और मिल्लत की बात नहीं होती है. हर तरह का आदमी यहाँ आता है. यहाँ किसी के ऊपर कोई पाबंदी नहीं है. यही तो हमारा सबसे बड़ा भाईचारा है. किसी के लिए कोई रोक और टोक नहीं है. किसी को जो है ये नहीं कहा जाता है आप फला मजहब के यहाँ मत आए. नहीं, यहाँ एक ऐसा भाईचारा बनाकर रखा हुआ है हम लोगों ने कि हर तरह का यहाँ आदमी आता है और फैजयाब होकर जाता.
As a part of the celebrations, Sufi scholars and imams sermon the public about the life, religious services, teachings and spiritual strength of the saint who devoted himself for the welfare of people. Community kitchen or langar was also set up to serve meal as a holy sacrament to the devotees from various communities. The holy commemoration clearly indicates that the lesson of love and compassion that was once propagated by the Sufi saints is still having its roots deeply embedded in the rich culture and traditions of India.
यहाँ हिंदू और मुसलमान का सवाल ही नहीं है, यहाँ इंसानियत का सवाल है. ये इंसान सब अल्लाह की मखलूक है और ये परिंदे दरिंदे ये भी रात को आते हैं और ये भी आके अपनी जो इनकी वो तमन्ना होती है जो इनकी बात होती है वो मना के जाते हैं.
मैं यहाँ जो ज़ियारत है ये बहुत मानी हुई ज़ियारत है. यहाँ पे काफ़ी दूर दूर से लोग यहाँ हर सालों साल यहाँ आते हैं. लंगर 24 घंटे यहाँ लगा रहता है. यहाँ किसी भी किस्म की कोई बीमारी हो वहाँ का यहाँ की इनकी दुआ से सब लोग ठीक हो जाते हैं. यहाँ भाईचारा हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई हर किस्म का मज़हब का लोग यहाँ आते हैं और यहाँ आकर अपनी मन्नत रखते हैं और उनकी दुआएँ जो हैं वो पूरी होती हैं.
Forming an integral part of Indian ethos for the last several centuries, even today, the Sufi traditions play an important role in the lives of the people and connote them with an understanding of the world in all its spiritual dimensions.
Spring season brings cool breeze, colors and sunshine. Celebrating the festival of greenery and blooming flower buds, flower shows and exhibitions are organized in different cities. One such spring festival was recently organized in the Dehradun city of Uttarakhand, which was a treat to the eye of visitors.
The onset of spring brings fresh blossoms of flowers and leaves, which makes the season very lively and colorful. A number of festivals are organized all over the country to celebrate the arrival of spring in different ways. While at some places people welcome by celebrating religious festivals, others celebrate by organizing flower shows and garden festivals. One such spring festival was organized in the northern state of Uttarakhand, where citizens celebrated the arrival of the flower festival.
यहाँ के फ्लावर एग्जीबिशन तो बहुत अच्छी लगी. तरह तरह के फूल हैं, काफ़ी वैराइटीज़ हैं इनमें. अच्छा लगा हम लोग को आकर के. यहाँ पे हम लोग जैसे डहलिया देखा और बोगनवेलिया देखा और भी काफ़ी वैराइटीज़ देखी. अब तो मुझे इतना नाम याद नहीं, लेकिन हाँ काफ़ी चीज़ें देखी हम लोगों ने. फ्लावर्स कटिंग की काफ़ी अच्छी वो लगी हुई हैं, एग्जीबिशन वगैरह. अच्छा है यहाँ.
Citizens across the state flocked to capital Dehradun to be part of the most colorful event in the city. Bunches of roses, daisies, lilies, and more such flowers were arranged in straight lines as citizens enjoyed taking a walk through nature. A total of 171 organizations who promote floriculture put up their stalls during the event. Apart from that, different competitions like flower petal painting were also organized, in which around 135 students participated. Later, the governor of Uttarakhand, Baby Rani Maurya, who was also the chief guest of the event, felicitated the winners of different competitions.
आज हमने बसंतोत्सव, फूलोत्सव, फ्लावर शो जो भी कहिए उसका उद्घाटन अभी हुआ है, और आप लोग स्वयं भी मेरे साथ थे, देख रहे हैं अनेक प्रकार के, अनेक प्रजातियों के फूल बॉन्साई, और हम कैसे प्रकृति से जुड़ें, कैसे नेचर से जुड़ें, इसका संदेश देती हुई कुछ फूलों से डेकोरेट करके वो लगाई हैं, फोटोग्राफ कहिए या झांकियां. तो सबसे बड़ा इसका उद्देश्य यही है कि हमें प्रकृति से प्यार करना सीखना चाहिए. इससे हमारा पर्यावरण भी अच्छा रहेगा, वायु शुद्ध रहेगी तो हमारा स्वास्थ्य भी अच्छा रहेगा. इसके साथ साथ जो हमारे अन्नदाता हैं, जो हमारे किसान हैं, उनकी आमदनी भी कैसे दुगनी हो, इस बात को भी यहाँ प्रमोट किया जा रहा है.
Steps like this can play a significant role in reviving the floriculture industry as well as inculcate habits of plantation and gardening among locals for collectively bringing about a change in the climatic conditions.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our new edition, World in Focus.
A wall of flower petals burst into 1,000 fragments. A huge bowl levitates in the air, turning from red to blue to purple. Hundreds of butterflies dart around a screen of tiny water particles. This is the latest creation of Japan's uber-popular team lab, comprising of engineers, artists and architects, anchored around a maze of 7 saunas lit up in hues of red, green and yellow. The Tokyo-based digital art group took over an empty lot in the city's glitzy Roppongi district and over the last year erected a massive tent housing the sauna, rooms and 3 immersive art installations.
We try to make the visitor to be in a very relaxed and it's a luxury the mindset, and so we use of the sauna's techniques like hot cold rest, hot cold rest, and that cycles. And after that, if you saw it in our artworks, or if you're one part of its artworks, maybe the experience gonna be much more richer than normal dimensions or it's in a normal mindset.
Opening during the pandemic meant seating spaces inside the biggest saunas had to be cut from 24 to 12 and ventilation adjusted to meet government standards for air circulation. Team Lab hopes to impact all senses of the visitors, including touch, sound and smells, such as roasted green tea in one of the saunas or white birch in another. Inspired by the native balloon flower, residents of Banwal and Bakji Islands, known as the Purple Islands in Southeast Korea, has transformed their towns into a tourist attraction. Here, almost everything is purple. The dresses worn by elderly women are in purple, the roofs of the houses they live in are also in different shades of violet, and the same in case of roads and bridges. Some have embraced the concept with gusto. The tiny tranquil islands have a little over 100 residents and were picked for a tourism project supported by the county and provincial governments. Since 2015, Shinan County has invested $4.25 million to turn the islands purple, including painting more than 28,000 square meters of roofs lilac. Restaurants on the islands even offer purple rice and serve food on purple plates. Visitors who adhere to the theme color are allowed free entry to the islands and can walk on three purple footbridges connecting the islands to the larger one nearby. Russians living in the town of Yuryevpolsky, 170 km from Moscow, recently marked the end of winter with a colorful Maslenitsa celebration. Festival participants, dressed in costumes, marched in the center of the town and after some activities and friendly competitions, burned the effigy of Maslenitsa. Burning the effigy marks the end of winter and was believed to fertilize the soil and bring a good harvest in the upcoming autumn.
Очень хорошо прошла масленица, долго очень сидели с этим ковидом, но сейчас все хорошо и на улице сегодня прекрасная погода, но очень хорошее гуляние.
Масленица is celebrated during the last week before the Christian festival of Lent, and it's a last chance in the upcoming weeks to eat dairies and meat that are forbidden during the upcoming fasting. Maslenitsa week began as a pagan ritual and has since been absorbed into the Russian Orthodox Christian tradition.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. Now we'll leave you with the visuals of beautiful sand art in Prayagraj city that was created on the occasion of National Vaccination Day. I'm your host Emma, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.